Hi, welcome back to Wesbury 101. I'm Brian Wesbury, Chief Economist at First Trust Portfolios. Remember, we want to be the antidote to conventional wisdom. Well, today, for sure, conventional wisdom is very worried about Europe. Nonetheless, I still think the U.S. is a plow horse economy and will remain a plow horse economy in the years ahead. First, let me just quickly address Europe. We've talked about it over and over and over again. I believe we are witnessing the end of the social welfare state. It's playing out ugly. It's going to take a long time. But the bottom line is Greece is likely to default on all its debt. The spending cuts that they need to make, probably 40% in order to bring their budget back into balance. They have to move toward austerity. Europe is fighting against this, but in general, they're going to move toward austerity and lots of defaults. Now the question is that going to harm the U.S.? And I would just remind all of you, 1988 and 89, everyone knew that Japan was a bubble or felt they knew. Japan cracked in 1990 and all during the 90s. It was an awful decade. There was lots of worry about what that would do to the U.S., and yet we had a boom. The same is true with the mid and late 1990s, with the Russian crisis and the Asian currency collapse. Also in 1983, every Latin and South American country, other than I think Chile and Colombia, went bankrupt. Our banks had massive loans to those countries, and yet in the 80s, we boomed. And so what I'm getting to is that Europe, it's huge, it's important, but the bottom line is that a decline in economic activity in Europe does not necessarily mean bad times for the United States. In fact, all those other times that I just pointed out, it didn't cause the good times, but it didn't preclude the good times in the U.S. economy. About 1.7% of GDP is our exports to Europe. If they went to zero, we would still grow. We would have grown about 0.5% last year. Right now, the five biggest banks in America have $36 billion of exposure to the pigs. They have $575 billion in capital. So I guess my point is that I don't think good things are happening in Greece. I think things are going to get much worse as time unfolds. But I also don't believe that that's going to take down the U.S. economy. And that brings me to my discussion of the plow horse. I have said that the U.S. economy is a plow horse economy. It ain't going to win the Belmont, for example, or the Preakness, or the Kentucky Derby. We hope Al have another finishes that sweep and wins the Triple Crown. But the U.S. economy ain't going to do that. But it ain't going to keel over and die either. And take a look at these two really simple charts. Here's real GDP growth on a quarterly basis. I went back to 2008. We had five declines out of six quarters in the recession of 2008, 2009. Five quarters were down out of six total. But now we have had 11 straight consecutive periods, quarters of growth in the United States. The average growth rate in the last 11 quarters has been 2.4%. We think GDP in the second quarter, which will make the 12th straight quarter of growth, will be right around 2 to 2.5, possibly a little bit stronger percent. So it's not going to change that. This plow horse keeps going through the rocks, through the stumps, through the mud, through all of the issues that the world seems to have these days. The U.S. economy keeps chugging along. And take a look at this chart. This shows private payrolls. That's those blue bars every month, and there's a big red circle around the last 26 months because we've had 26 consecutive months of private sector job growth in the United States. The gold line on that chart is consumer confidence, and as you can see, it's been coming up, but it's still at very, very, very low levels. And what this shows is that the plow horse isn't enough to get people excited about the future. Having said that, though, U.S. corporations are more profitable than they have ever been, and we believe that this plow horse is likely to gain some momentum as the year ahead unfolds. There are very important political events on June 5th, Scott Walker recall vote in Wisconsin, probably sometime in late June. Let's just call it June 25th. We don't know the date. The Supreme Court will rule on Obamacare in November. We have an election in the United States, a very important election. And the big question for the world today is, are we going to learn the lessons of the collapse of the social welfare state? If we do, the plow horse will turn into a racehorse. My view is that if we can turn around spending and have it declining as a share of GDP and avoid tax hikes, this plow horse economy that has grown despite mistakes out of Washington and mistakes in a lot of countries around the world will begin to accelerate and actually turn into a racehorse. So yes, the market is down today. Yes, the Treasury bond market shows abject fear of the future, but I think those fears are misplaced like they have been over the past 3 years. Thanks so much for visiting Wesbury 101. We'll see you next time.